As of September 22nd of 2024, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes, which produced either the second or third largest explosive eruption of the 20th century, depending on the source, is Guatemala's Santa Maria volcano. The aforementioned powerful eruption in 1902 left behind a giant scar in the main mountain from which a flame clavidome complex known as Santiaguito has grown ever since. Santiaguito has been continuously erupting since 1922, producing repeated volcanic eruptions that often generate associated pyroclastic flows. But first, keeping up with the latest scientific news like what I'm covering today is becoming challenging. It's why I cover geologic topics not widely discussed by major news outlets, and why today's extended duration video is sponsored by Ground News. Ground News makes it easier to make sense of the news, save time on researching, and keep properly informed. They do this by gathering articles from across the world into one place and providing unique context about each source. This includes a source's political leanings, ownership, and general factual reliability. I personally love Ground News for their blind spot feature, which helps to show you important news stories that you otherwise would have likely missed due to your own political leanings. Ground News can even help you identify your own biases through the My News Bias page, with this being the biases it identified for me personally based on my reading habits. I only take sponsorships from brands I trust and wouldn't recommend them if I didn't think it was relevant for my audience or if I didn't use the platform myself. Go to ground.news/geologyhub to give it a try with plans starting as low as 83 cents a month. If you sign up through my link, you'll get 40% off the Vantage plan, which is what I use for access to all their features. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the Spanish Canary Islands, a swarm of earthquakes struck adjacent to the underwater volcano known as Enmedio, which has no historical eruptions. Heading over to the Portuguese Azores Islands, adding to the increasing unrest of the Terceira volcano, its Serrata submarine ridge had its alert level raised from V0 to V1. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the rate of earthquakes and sulfur dioxide emissions once again spiked at the Kanlaon volcano, probably due to the presence of shallow magma. And, in what is this week's top story, Hawaii's Kilauea volcano produced its first east rift zone eruption since 2018, sending lava fountains as much as 20 meters or 66 feet into the air. This brand new eruption began on September 15th after 3 months of magma building in this very region, occurring specifically in a 1.1 mile long band within and just west of a pit crater known as Napao Crater. This eruption occurred in four phases, with each phase involving less than 36-hour-long bursts of eruptive activity with either lesser activity or pauses of lava effusion between them. While molten rock initially burned some remote patches of forest, later phases saw molten rock flow into Napao Crater, creating spectacular 50-meter, 164-foot-high lava falls. Some material even then erupted within Napao Crater proper via a series of 10 small fissure segments. This eruption, at least as of the writing of this video, had entered another pause after lava effusion stopped on September 20th, although this could actually represent the true end of Kilauea's second longest Middle East rift zone eruption since 1979. In total, 0.559 square kilometers or 138.24 acres of ground was covered in the layer of lava from this eruption. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, there is once again a risk of the Kanlaon volcano producing its first magmatic eruption in more than a century due to its absurdly high daily sulfur dioxide emissions, which were most recently measured at 10,228 tons a day on September 20th. This is a stunningly high figure for a volcano which is not actively erupting, and such high levels indicate a likelihood of abundant magma at a depth of less than a kilometer below ground. For a quick comparison, during Kilauea's eruption this week, when lava effusion was actively ongoing, sulfur dioxide emissions maxed out at only 10,000 tons a day. While a rapid spike in earthquakes and gas emissions on September 10th through 12th did not lead to an eruption, earthquake levels thereafter declined but have intensified once again since September 19th. This suggests that there is now, once again, an elevated chance of a volcanic eruption occurring here, hence Kanlaon's active 4-kilometer exclusion zone in all directions around its summit. Currently, Kanlaon's geophysical data fits all three criteria observed before the vast majority of its historical eruptions. In the Canary Islands, a swarm of earthquakes struck between the volcanic islands of Tenerife and Gran Canaria. This earthquake swarm peaked between September 7th and 12th, creating 22 earthquakes large enough to be felt on the coastlines of the adjacent islands via magnitude 2 and 3 range events. These events were strangely centered east of a little-known submarine volcano known as Enmedio, but we do not know if they were truly volcanic or tectonic in origin. However, I personally deem a tectonic origin to be more likely. You see, like many mantle hotspot-caused volcanic island chains, there is a progression of younger to older islands. Due to erosion and the lack of or low volume of recent eruptive activity on several of the older islands, the crust which is floating on top of the mantle became less thick. This caused the crust to be slightly uplifted on several of the older islands, including Tenerife and Gran Canaria. Yet, for some reason, the area between these two islands appears to undergo a higher rate of uplift, which causes uneven strain that likely generated the ongoing earthquake swarm. And, in the Azores, slow ground deformation is continuing to occur at the Terceira volcano, along with a rate of increased earthquakes. However, during the last month, some earthquakes began also occurring on its Cereda submarine ridge, resulting in that ridge's alert level being raised from V0 to V1. While activity levels do not seem high enough to signal an imminent eruption anytime soon on or adjacent to this volcanic island, this is an interesting development in the step-by-step slow escalation the island's volcano has experienced during the last 3 years. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on September 21st of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Robert Grund for supporting this channel.